Hi everyone, welcome to Winpoint Online Classes. Today we are going to discuss the system of resistors. The topics which we are going to cover in this session are effective resistance, equations for effective resistance, numerical. We are going to end this session with some of the numerical. Let's start the discussion. First we can discuss resistance of a system of resistors. What do you mean by system? System means there will be more than one resistor. Resistor is a component in an electric circuit which is used to control the amount of electric current. There are different types of connection for resistor: series connection and parallel connection. This arrangement is known as series connection. You can see it is in a straight line. It is a series connection. This resistor is R1, R2 and R3. And the second type, we can see that here these resistors are parallel to each other. So this type of connection is known as parallel connection. So there are two types of connection: series connection and parallel connection. This is R1, R2 and R3. Now we are going to discuss how to find the total resistance of circuit, whether it is parallel connection or series connection. Before that, we need to learn some of the properties of this type of connection. Let's learn that first. First we can discuss series connection. Here you can see a circuit. This circuit consists of resistors. Three resistors are there. There are three resistors, and here you can see ammeter. Ammeter is used to measure electric current in circuit, and there is a key, and it is battery. Battery is the combination of cells. The resistors are R1, R2 and R3. Now you can see a voltmeter. Voltmeter is used to measure potential difference between two ends of this conductor. Here there are three resistors. We are going to use this voltmeter to measure the potential difference between this point and this point. Battery is having positive and negative sign. This side is positive and this side is negative. Positive and negative, and positive terminal of the battery is connected to positive terminal of the ammeter. So here it is positive and it is negative. The positive terminal of the battery, here it is a positive terminal of the battery. This positive terminal should be connected to positive terminal of the voltmeter. It is a connection. Can you guess the direction of current flow? The current flow is always starting from positive terminal of the battery. The current will flow towards negative terminal of the battery. So this is the current flow, the direction of current flow. At this point, you can see that the current will split. The current is splitting into two, and here the current is combining again and it is coming to the battery back. In series connection, the current through each resistor will be same. If it is I, the current through this resistor is I, and this one is also I, and this one will be also I. The current through each resistor will be same. What about potential difference? The potential difference will be different. Here the potential difference is V1. The potential difference between two ends of R1, it is V1. The potential difference between two ends of R2, it is V2. The potential difference between two ends of R3, it is V3. In series connection, the potential difference will be different for different resistors, and current will be same in all the resistors. Very important point. In series connection, potential differences are different for different resistors. The current will be the same in each resistor. Parallel connection. It is parallel connection. Can you see three resistors here? Yes, R1, R2 and R3. There are three resistors. Here there is a voltmeter. Voltmeter should be always parallel to the resistor. That's why we are making a separate connection. And ammeter is always inside the circuit. It is in series connection. And this positive end of the battery, negative end of the battery. Now, we are going to discuss the distribution of voltage and current. In parallel connection, the voltage will be the same. In each resistor, the voltage will be same, but current will be different. It is the direction of current flow here. Current through this R1, it is I1. The current through R2, it is I2. The current through R3, it is I3. Here you can see I1, I2, I3. The current, it is different. But what about potential difference? The potential difference will be same. V, V, V. In parallel connection, the potential differences are same, but the value of currents are different. In parallel connection, potential differences are same across all resistors. The values of current are different for different resistors. Effective resistance. If you are taking a circuit, in the circuit there will be resistors. The total resistance of the resistors is known as effective resistance. The total resistance of resistors is known as effective resistance. If you are considering a circuit, the total resistance of circuit, that is effective resistance. Now we can define effective resistance. Total resistance of a circuit is known as effective resistance. Equations for effective resistance. Series connection. These are resistors R1, R2, R3. These resistors are connected in series. And we are going to connect these resistors with the battery. So it is a battery. Now we have a battery here. In series connection, the voltage will be different for different resistors. The voltage of R1, it will be different. R2, it will be different. R3, it will be different. But the current will be the same. A voltage of battery, it is V. Here the voltage will be V1, V2, V3. But what about current? That current is same. It will be I, because there is no change in current in series connection. How we can find total voltage of the circuit? There are three voltages here, V1, V2, V3. How we can find total voltage or total potential difference? To find total potential difference, we can add it. Means we can add V1, V2 and V3. V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. That is the equation. According to Ohm's law, what is the equation for V? According to Ohm's law, the equation for V is I into R. So what about V1? It will be I into R1. What about V2? It will be I into R2. What about V3? I into R3. The equation for voltage is IR. Here V1, V2, V3 means I into R1 plus I into R2 plus I into R3. So we can write V equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. Now we are going to do one thing. We are going to change these three resistors. We are going to replace that three resistors with a single resistor. We are changing that resistors and we are placing a single resistor. The value of resistance R, current I and voltage is V. What will be the potential difference across this resistor? It will be V equal to IR. So instead of this V, we can substitute IR. Then it will be IR equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. In this equation, I is common. I is common, we are going to take it out. It will be IR equal to I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. I and I, it will cancel each other. It will be, the equation will be R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. In series connection, the effective resistance, how we can find effective resistance? The equation is R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. For the exam, you need to write everything. You need to draw this diagram and you need to write this explanation, this derivation. Next one, equation for effective resistance, parallel connection. There are three resistors. These three resistors are connected in parallel. The three resistors are connected in parallel. It is connected to a battery. The voltage of this battery is V. R1, R2, R3. In parallel connection, the current through each resistor is different, but voltage is same. Voltage will be V because the voltage, the potential difference is same in every conductor. What about current? Current is different for different resistor. It will be I1 for R1, I2 for R2. I3 for R3. There are three current and three resistors. How we can find total current of the circuit? We are going to find total current. How we can find the total current? Total current is I and that current is splitting into I1, I2, I3. So total current will be I equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. According to Ohm's law, what is the equation for I? It is V by R. So we can write here it is I1. So it will be V by R1. I2 V by R2, I3 V by R3. So we can substitute all the values in the equation. It will be I equal to V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. Now we are going to do the same thing here. We are going to change this all resistors. Here you can see three resistors. We are going to change that resistors. Instead of that, we are adding a new resistor. The value of resistor is R. The resistance is R and voltage is V, current is I. Here you can see I, V and resistor is R. The value of resistance is R. What is the current through this resistor now? There is a resistor. What is the current through this resistor? It is V by R. Because only one resistor and voltage is V, I equal to V by R. We are going to substitute that value here. It will be V by R equal to V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. V is common in this equation. We are taking it out. It will be V by R equal to V into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. V and V will cancel each other. It will be 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. It is equation for effective resistance in parallel connection. For the exam, you need to draw this diagram and you need to write everything. You need to practice this method, then it will be very easy for you. Equations for effective resistance. These are the equations for effective resistance. Series connection, R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Parallel connection, 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. These are the two equations. Now we are going to discuss some of the numerical related to this equation. First question. An electric lamp whose resistance is 20 ohm and a conductor of 4 ohm resistance are connected to a 6 volt battery. Calculate. Question A. The total resistance of the circuit. Question B. The current through the circuit. And question C. The potential difference across the electric lamp and conductor. There are 3 questions. We need to find effective resistance and we need to find current and we need to find potential difference. First we can go for question A. When you are getting a numerical, the first step is write the given values. You need to write the given values. First you need to read the question, then you need to write the given values. We are going to read the question. The total resistance of circuit. We need to find total resistance of circuit. Question A. An electric lamp whose resistance is 20 ohm. Resistance is given. Value of resistor is given 20 ohm. And a conductor of 4 ohm. There are two resistors. Here you can see in the circuit there are two resistors. We need to find effective resistance. Which type of connection is this? Series or parallel? There are two resistors. Resistor number 1, 4 ohm. Resistor number 2, 20 ohm. It is in series connection. So the equation is R equal to R1 plus R2. Only there are two resistors. That's why we are using this one. If there are four resistors, equation will be R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4. Here there are two resistors. What is the value of R1? It is 4 ohm. You can take 20 ohm also. It will be R1 equal to 4 ohm, R2 equal to 20 ohm. Then it will be R equal to 4 plus 20. It will be 24 ohm. Now we can go for question B. The current through the circuit. It is series connection. In series connection, the current is same. So just we can apply that Ohm's law. We need to use this value of R, then only we can find current. So we are keeping that value over there. And what is the value of V? V, the value of V is given in the question. In the diagram, you can see the value of V is 6. 6 volt battery. We connected 6 volt battery. So V is 6 volt. What is the equation for current I according to Ohm's law? I equal to V by R. That is equation. And what is the value of V? V is 6 volt and R is 24 volt. So it will be 6 by 24 is equal to 0.25 ampere. That is the value of current. Now third question. The potential difference across the electric lamp and conductor. We need to find the potential difference. In series connection, the potential difference is different. The voltage is different for different resistors. First, we are going to find the potential difference across 4 ohm resistor. After that, we are going to find potential difference across 20 ohm resistor. First, we can go for 4 ohm resistor. The value of R1, it is 4 ohm and value of R2 is 20 ohm. We are going to find the voltage, the potential difference across each resistor. The current is same. So we can use the same value, I equal to 0.25 ampere. According to Ohm's law, what is the equation for voltage? It is I into R. Then it will be V1 equal to IR1. And the value of I is 0.25. 0.25 into 4, it is 1 volt. If we are finding V1, it is very easy to find V2. Just subtract that value from the total voltage. Here total voltage is 6. We got 1, 6 minus 1, 5. We are going to find the answer using the equation. V2 equal to IR2. What is the value of R2? 20 ohm. What is the value of I? 0.25. It will be 0.25 into 20 equal to 5 volt. Now we can go for next question. If you are listening to this class, keep a book with you. Write the answer. When I am explaining here, you need to write the answer. Then only the method will be easy for you. Then you can do it alone. After listening to this class, it will be very easy to solve it. Second question. In the figure, R1 equal to 10 ohm, R2 equal to 40 ohm, R3 equal to 30 ohm, R4 equal to 20 ohm, R5 equal to 60 ohm. There are 5 resistors. And a 12 volt battery is connected to the arrangement. And there is a 12 volt battery. Calculate the total resistance in the circuit. Question B, the total current flowing in the circuit. There are 2 questions. Total resistance or effective resistance and total current. And the circuit is given. This is the circuit. In this circuit, there are 5 resistors. Here you can see 5 resistors. R1, R2, R3, R4, R5. 5 resistors. How we can solve it? method is very easy. First we can go for question A. Here you can see the resistors R1, R2, R3, R4, R5. Is it parallel connection or series connection? There are 5 resistors. We are splitting that resistors into 2 groups. First group, second group. First group and second group. So these 2 are in first group. These 3 are in second group. First we are considering these 2. Is it parallel or series? These 2, there is no doubt it is parallel connection. Similarly, R3, R4, R5, they are also in parallel. So we are going to apply our equation. First we are going to find effective resistance of these 2 resistors. What is the equation? 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. What is the value of R1? R1 is 10 ohm, R2 is 40 ohm. It is given in the question. You need to read the question. R1 is 10 ohm, R2 is 40 ohm. We are going to substitute the value here. It will be 1 by R equal to 1 by 10 plus 1 by 40. Fractions. You need to take the LCM. Here LCM is 40. So it will be 1 by R equal to 4 plus 1 by 40. It will be 1 by R equal to 5 by 40. R equal to 40 by 5. Which means what is 40 by 5? It is 8 ohm. Now we got the value. The effective resistance of these 2 resistors, we found the value, it is 8 ohm. We are writing that value here. Now we are going for the second group, R3, R4, R5. There are 3 resistors. What will be the equation then? 1 by R equal to 1 by R3 plus 1 by R4 plus 1 by R5. What are the values of R3, R4 and R5? It is there in the question. R3 equal to 30 ohm, R4 equal to 20 ohm, R5 equal to 60 ohm. We are going to substitute all the values. It will be 1 by R equal to 1 by 30 plus 1 by 20 plus 1 by 60. Here also you need to take LCM. If you are solving this, it will be 1 by R equal to 2 plus 3 plus 1 all divided by 60. 1 by R equal to 6 by 60. It will be R by 1 equal to 60 by 6. R equal to 10 ohm. Now we got that value also. This value also we are going to write it here. The circuit was complicated. We reduced the complication. Now there is only one resistor, 8 ohm. There is another resistance, 10 ohm. Is it in series or parallel? Current is flowing through the circuit and it is in same line. The 2 resistors are in same line, which means it is in series connection. What is the equation for effective resistance if the resistors are in series connection? R equal to R1 plus R2. R will be equal to 8 plus 10, it will be 18 ohm. So we got the effective resistance of entire circuit, it is 18 ohm. Question B. The total current flowing in the circuit. The total current means we need to use Ohm's law. It is in series connection now. 18 ohm is the effective resistance. It is in series connection. What will be the total current? Total current I equal to V by R. What is the value of V? The value of V is here, it is 12 volt. So 12 volt and R is 18 ohm. I will be equal to 12 by 18 equal to 0.66 ampere. It is the answer. If you like this video, please share this video, subscribe to my channel, visit our website www.winpointonlineclasses.com. Support us for providing free online classes to everyone. You can always ask your doubt using comment box. Thanks for watching.